Assalamu alaikum and greetings. Hello everybody, how are you? Welcome to my little man cave at night, and welcome to the late night show. As mentioned in this little live show, I'm not sure how long I'm gonna be here, kind of feeling really sleepy today. But hey, let's talk about the video goggles, of course. I have got myself about 5 video goggles sitting right here, so I'm gonna start introducing them one by one. And starting from right side, I have boxed goggles, and sitting right here are all those twin LCD based goggles. Now, I remember when I started flying FPV, I was actually looking for goggles, and I'm not sure what year was that. I have to go back and see some of my old videos, video receivers, video transmitters, cameras used to be big and trouble to put on. Yes, it is nighttime here. So I remember that in the beginning there was LCD screens, and then came the SkyZone goggles. I believe my very first goggle was the SkyZone goggle, and that actually looked like something like this. Okay, it was completely this kind of design, except give me a moment, except this. Okay, so there was a plastic frame here, I mean plastic cover here, so that it won't hurt eyes. So my first goggles, I believe, were like these. And of course, I do remember with a little bit confusion that I also got a Fat Shark that time. That was the earliest Fat Shark video goggles. I'm just gonna put it on my head right here. FPV president, inshallah, someday I will be FPV president. Well, so now I'm still debating that was my first goggle SkyZone or a Fat Shark. I do remember I had a Fat Shark for quite a while, and I was a big fan of Fat Shark because those were really nice goggles. And that time they had only one antenna, so you had a choice of only one antenna to go for whatever type you want. So should you want to fly long range, you would do that with a patch antenna, or long range you know, heli antenna. I hope the voice is clear on the microphone. Let me see, I believe it is still recording. So yes, after that I remember I got stuck with the SkyZone goggles, which were like this for a very, very long time. And then started coming the, how to say, boxed goggles. After a long time, people realized that, you know, they can actually, it will take a while for me to put this on, one moment. People realized that, hey, what if they, you know, put an LCD inside a box and put a Fresnel lens on it. So came something like this. Hey, you can see my reflection here. Ooh, I made a tunnel right there. Check this out, that infinite tunnel. All right, so yes, they realized you can put an LCD inside a box and put a Fresnel lens on it, okay? And call that a boxed video goggle, something like this. Well, it was good, and it did work right, because you could actually put an HD LCD in it, 1920 1080p HD LCD in it, and you could have a lens to make it look really large. So boxed goggles came, and in the beginning I didn't like them because I was hooked with twin LCD. So those were, remember, I was hooked on SkyZones for a very, very, very long time. So when the box goggles came, people said, hey, the box goggles are really nice and this and that. And I was not ready to move the LCD on my face, because when you put these on face, you know, there's a difference, see? Small and big, right? So anyway, I did try a couple of boxed goggles, but one boxed goggle actually stayed with me for a very, very long time. And that was the boxed goggle that actually got me really, really interested into using boxed goggles. And I actually switched a couple of boxed goggles after that, but nothing satisfied me. This box goggle was the only goggle that stayed with me for over 2 years or more, I believe, longest period of time after SkyZones. And that is Ishin VR D2 Pro. I still cannot let it go. I don't know why. I mean, I have sold out most of my video goggles, but this is something that I'm not ready to let go. I have no idea why. The Ishin VR D2 Pro has been really worthy and valuable for each and every penny I spent on these. These video goggles, honestly, not that clear compared to goggles like this. I mean, the LCD is not very, but the screen is very, very big, and the DVR in this one was one of the best DVRs I have ever used. The DVR in this one recorded 16:9, big wide angle picture and image, and it was a good quality. And I don't know why, a couple of people, definitely I heard that they were, complaining about it, but I have never had any issues. Some people complain that the firmware problem, this, that, but I have never actually did anything regarding firmware, DVR, or something like that. This thing totally stock since the time it came, totally stock until now it is here. Never had a single issue. So these are some kind of goals. I mean, these are kind of goals that stayed with me and gonna stay here, inshallah, with me. So if you are a fan of box video goggles, Ishin VR D2 Pro are a good place to start with. I see that I think the Ishin VR there's a newest version of these boxed goggles and with some improvements on it. However, I didn't want to go for it because they shrank the size, made it even smaller, for a big face, a small, my face is not very big, but they made it smaller, and I thought, it's time to move on from the box goggles to other goggles. So I went ahead, I got myself a V2 from SkyZone. They stayed with me quite a while for now. I believe when I was in Dubai, I got these and I started to fly with these. The reception, video reception was right, but I didn't like the DVR in this because of that 4:3 ratio recording on the DVR. Hello GZ11, I believe that's the right name, right? Hold on, Eric, I will be answering all the questions very soon. So yes, the DVR in these video goggles I didn't like. And I mean, these are really, really nice video goggles. SkyZone V2, these are the V2 I'm talking about. Why? Because there's no fan here. V3, right here, they have a fan right there. So not much difference, but there's a fan here and, more features in this. We'll talk about that. So what issues I had with this? I love these goggles. They've been very, very good. I've been using them and I loved it. The issue I had with this was that one day they just stopped working. I have no idea why, but SkyZone has been very, very nice. I sent the goggles back to them and like 1 or 2 days, they returned the goggles back and they were working. So I'm really happy that it's still working. Now, the issue, once again, the next issue was, there's no fan. So during winter, especially now this season, there's a lot of fog in these video goggles. When you're wearing and flying, the fog will start building up and you have to, take it off, blow on it to release the fog. Remove the fog and fly back. So, the fogging up inside the lenses is really not a good thing, and it really disturbs your FPV flying. That was an issue. Now, the other issue SkyZone mentioned, they said they had a recall on these goggles for a very funny issue. The issue was that the foreigners have long nose, especially here, And probably they designed it for, smaller nose. So they had an issue with foreigners' long nose not fitting in right here. And basically this not being comfortable on bigger faces or foreigner faces. So they had a recall, and they had to change the design and release the V3. Now, I really do not see much difference when it comes to, I hope you can see it, I really do not see much difference when it comes to the nose area. See what I'm talking about? Okay, so I do not see much difference. What happened that anyway, people have to move on. So that was one issue. But hey, honestly speaking, I never had that issue with a longer nose or these goggles being uncomfortable on my faces. Hey, good man, MKW, I'll be right back. You cannot get hold of me in USA because I'm in China right here. All right, so we'll continue with the questions. Hold on. So they have never been, there hasn't been any issue of these goggles being uncomfortable on my face. Anyway, I then got myself the V3. Now, I love the V3 for the reason that they had a fan. So there's no more fogging issue now. You can defog the goggles lenses inside, no more fogging issue. And the thing I love about them is they are really quick to scan the channels, the frequencies. So the frequencies that you want to lock onto, all you need to do is press and hold this button for 1 or 2 seconds and then press it again. And it locks, scans all the frequencies, all the channels really, really quick and lock onto the strongest signal, and you can press and hold the button and that's it, you're done. And when it comes to recording the DVR, just one button right here, just press it once, the DVR menu comes, I mean the DVR, the OSD comes up, and then press again and starts recording, press again and stop recording. So DVR really, really fast. And definitely they have improved the DVR in this one. Now DVR records real good quality compared to the older one. And if your goggles turn off accidentally, the DVR will save the file in there. So basically, I love the design. Again, I had no issue with the nose or being uncomfortable, except that a lot of light. I'm using this faceplate. Hold on, let me push it back in. I'm not breaking it. I'm using this faceplate, okay, and a thick foam, you can see, thick foam. But still, a lot of light will slip from these two corners and under the similar way. A lot of light will slip in and sometimes cause glare. Apart from that, I have never had any more issues. The diversity receiver works really, really nice in these SkyZone O3. And if you use directional and omnidirectional antenna, you can get really, really nice reception. I have actually flown 6+ kilometer with the SkyZone goggles and my mini Talon. You can see it, it's hanging right there. So, on that plane, I have actually flown 6+ kilometer glitch-free video using these video goggles. And hold on, I'll be right back. And this antenna, this is Aeon Way Diamond Directional A Antenna 009. So I had this antenna here and one, I believe, omnidirectional antenna. I went 6+ kilometers with these goggles glitch-free. So, yes, one moment. I also like the LED in front here. The front LED, you can change colors. It makes it look really nice, especially at night. And that these goggles, the SkyZone goggles, have a front camera. So sometimes when you're wearing the goggles, you need to see your model. And for that, you need to take your goggles off and look at the model, where the model is, where it's going to take off from. But with the SkyZones, you don't have to take the video goggles off. You just have to, press this camera button right here once and activate the front camera so you can see anything. You can walk around, stuff like that. So this is really, really nice. So again, I will say these are one of my best favorite goggles, V3. And guess what? Now they're going to release a new one with OLEDs. Means much more clear picture and image in there. I hope they improve other features as well, or add a feature of taking the external receivers, video receivers, aftermarket open source receivers to take in like Fat Sharks. Okay, I don't know. I have been away from Fat Shark for a very, very long time, maybe because of the price or something like that. But hey, these are not cheap either anyway. So the SkyZone V3 are still my very, very best favorite. No issues except that light slips in, and sometimes if the antenna's choice is wrong, you will have a bad time flying your model around. But video reception is pretty nice on this one. And then finally, I recently received, we'll come back to the box goggles again, but then finally I have received the Ishin EV200D. And they're staying top of my list, top of my favorite FPV video goggles, because this is the set B, and it came with two diversity video receivers, and I can use four antenna. That's the number stuck in my head. One moment, I'm coming back to the questions. All right. So, yes, having to have a feature where you can have quadversity, two true diversity video receivers, and you can use four different antennas. This gives you one of the most solid video downlink for flying FPV, especially FPV racing quadcopters that you have to go through gates. Yeah, you're flying in a jungle, in a forest, going through trees. You're doing some challenge freestyling, or you know, obstacle course flying, obstacle course freestyling. The quadversity is going to give you the strongest possible signal, and you will love to fly your models, you know, for those obstacle courses. Now, these are heavy, nice build, and really worthy video goggles from Ishin. Now, we'll come to the price very, very soon. Now, this has twin video receivers, and it has an ability to take aftermarket open source video receivers. Now, I hope the Ishin will actually release, after testing, or they should know which one of it, they should release a list of aftermarket open source video receivers, diversity video receivers that will fit in this video goggles and will still give us quadversity. So the thing is, the quadversity is given or done using the two diversity receivers that the set B comes with. But there's still a question, is quadversity still possible if you're using, say, True D and a real ace? So here's a real ace and there's a True D, or can you use Fat Shot? So they should give us a list, number one, that which kind of video receivers are compatible with, and we know where to buy them. Yeah, even on Banggood.com, they should have it. So list them and where to buy them. And second, tell us if using two different companies' video receivers, diversity video receivers, will we have, this antenna is loose, will we have quadversity or not? So that is one question, which should be answered by Ishin only. Otherwise, people like us, reviewer who review these videos and test, review these products and test, I have to spend money, buy those, video receivers, put them in and see if we have quadversity or not. But how would we know if there's a quadversity unless we dig into, the electronics? And I don't have any tools and I don't have qualification to dig into those electronics. So Ishin can answer these questions really easily. Will you have quadversity if you use two different companies' diversity video receivers? But again, having to have a feature that you can take open source aftermarket diversity video receivers in a video goggle, that's a big plus here. And then we have a fan for defogging. We have a DVR, we have a menu, and we have a 16:9 1280 720p LCD screen. We have adapter lenses option. We have IPD adjustment. We have HDMI in, we have AV in. I don't know if these are AV in or out. What if we wanted AV out? That is something, right? So my current favorite are these. But again, when it comes to what I don't like about Ishin EV200D, well, yes, I should, again, pick them up and say, what I don't like about Ishin EV200D is, number one, the auto scan feature. To get into auto scan feature, you have to press and hold mode button for 8-9 seconds, this is a long time. And once you enter that mode, it's really slow to scan. It does scan all the channels for you and lock onto the strongest signal, but it is pretty, pretty slow compared to SkyZone all three video goggles right here. Now, you have watched my latest videos, FPV video goggles battle, where I compared these two video goggles, and you have seen that while I was locking the signals, I mean, I was scanning the signals with the Ishin EV200D, these goggles, I turned them on, I scanned the signals, and they actually, I scanned the frequency, and they actually locked on really quicker than these ones. So that is one thing I don't like. I hope Ishin can do something about scanning process that make it like one click or something, give us another button for auto scanning, something like that, and make it a bit faster. DVR is the other thing. The same thing you have to do for the DVR, you have to enter the DVR menu for pressing the button for 6 seconds or more, and then you will be able to stop the recording on the DVR. So using the user interface, that's what we should say, is not very, fast or convenient on Ishin VR D2 Pro, but here it's really, really fast on Sky Zones. But again, I'm giving preference to these video goggles over these, is because Quadversity and I have a real, real solid link. I have recently been flying, weather was bad, but weather was good in between. I have been flying my, I have a Diatom, two Diatoms there, and I also got my Emax Hawk 5 ready, sitting right there over backside as well. And honestly speaking, compared to these ones, boy, I have been flying those FPV quadcopters, racing quadcopters with these all the time, Skyzone V3. But now when I flew them with EV200D, hey, experience is honestly very, very different. Solid link, no glitch, nothing. It's really different experience. So again, now my personal favorite are the EV200D. Will I use Fat Shark? Hold on, Mr. Del, just a moment. Will I get Fat Shark? Not sure, but hey, it's worth a try to get a Fat Shark as well. Now, for the boxed video goggles, I got myself recently the Toby Ridge, which are probably the similar to Ishin EV007 or 006. And what I like about these is that Toby Ridge has actually improved something in this. They have provided a live stream recorder that is a built-in DVR, a very fast channel scanning, and of course, ability to take a still shot from your DVR by clicking one button only. And my best favorite part for these video goggles is that you can detach them. Simply don't use it. And put it on a tripod, use it standalone like an LCD. So when it comes to the box goggle, my personal favorite are still Ishin VR D2 Pro, but time by time I do use Toby Ridge with me. And of course, Toby Ridge are my kids' personal favorite because they love to watch FPV when I fly. Now I have a lot of goggles, so basically whole family and even friends can watch FPV flights. So there you go. These were my current experiences, my personal experiences with these FPV video goggles. In the box video goggles, I have VR D2 Pro. There's a new one from Ishin with 1080p video resolution, LCD resolution, full HD. Has a DVR in it, kind of triangular shape. I'm trying to get them and see how good they are as a box goggle. And then I have Sky Zones and Ishin EV200D, my current best favorite Ishin EV200D at the moment. So these were all about video goggles. Moving on to the questions. Hold on, let me read it. Sorry for talking too much. Eric says, hi, can I use it on Bugs 5W? Hey, if Bugs 5W transmits on 5.8 GSZ, so anything that transmits on 5.8 GSZ, I hope you're talking about EV200D or Skyzone 02 or Skyzone 03, anything 5.8 GSZ, of course, they will receive if it is in, you know, the spectrum of frequency. But I believe Bugs 5W does not have 5.8 GSZ. They transmit on over a Wi-Fi, and that's why it's the video glitches and freezes very quick. All right, and then Barracuda Pro Barracuda says, can you do a mini RC car with FPV on the next video? Hey, I will give it a try. Mini RC car. FPV on an RC car, I'm not sure I have a mini or not, but I have got a couple of RC cars that I'm going to review on the back. There's a Helifar six-wheel drive sitting there, and my personal favorite, the HPG four-wheel drive, the Tamiya copy. The Tamiya, it's really sad how people copying each other. I mean, here, the old, especially the old classic like Tamiya, we are going totally away from the topic here of the FPV goal. But again, hey, check it out. What's coming next on my channel? So, yes, that is a Tamiya copy. And then I have a Zombie 8E 180 scale from DHK Hobby and a couple of more coming. I'm also trying to get, you know, pocket is getting thinner. Nobody's listening, everybody's sleeping. I'm also trying to get a gasoline Baja. So I believe I can do some FPV on probably that truck. That would be really nice to do FPV on that. Message retracted. Okay, I cannot read Chinese here, but there's a Chinese name here. I have myopia. I have to choose to buy the Yixin VR007 or the EV100. I'm in a hurry to know. Thank you. Hey, why do you want to go for EV100? EV200? For myopia? I'm not sure if these goggles are good or box goggles. I'm trying to get another box goggle, that 1080p HD. Maybe you might want to wait. Drop me an email. We'll talk more about it. Which goggles are really, really nice, boxed or if EV200D. But again, it comes to the budget, how much budget you have. Hello, Raven. And then Mr. Dull. Sorry, Mr. Dull. Mac, I don't know. I'm really sorry. No-go school for English. I cannot pronounce that name. But Mr. Dull, what goggles format gives the best view as far as navigating and maneuvering through and around obstacles? Now, though, this is, again, a personal choice. I would say this is a personal choice. Some people are very, very comfortable with boxed goggles. There was a time I was really very comfortable with boxed goggles and using LCD-based goggles. I couldn't fly much better. So, and some people are comfortable with this. So, again, it is depending upon, you know, what you're comfortable with, what you start with. Basically, if you start with you get your very first goggle, a box goggle or an LCD base, then you can have a really good time to get adjusted to those video goggles and you will have fun with that. But again, according to my very, very personal taste and choices and experience, I've been using box goggles. I have used LCD to fly FPV racing quadcopters as well. I feel that these kind of goggles that fit snug on your face real nice, and they have nice LCDs, very high resolution LCDs, they are much more better to fly obstacle course, actually. So that's my personal experience, but again, it's a personal choice. Sorry to keep you waiting, Mr. Dove. So Andy Drew FPV, same as the Yixin EV800D. Yep, I believe you're talking about these, right? All right. Sporting Vlogs, can you review the Exceed Nitro Forza RC? Yeah, that's a good question, man. Very good question, Mr. Pie Lover, Sporting and Vlogs. Yes, it's been a long time. I've been away from a Nitro engine just because they're dirty, they're noisy, and the fumes is poison, and they leave your hands really, really oily. But I found recently, once just before yesterday or before that, I was in my downstairs storeroom, I found I still have two bottles of Nitro sitting here. I don't know if that Nitro can still be used or not, but hey, I'm looking at one or two Nitro cars, but if I can get Exceed, I'm looking at HSP, one of the HSP Nitro cars, and to be honest, Exceed is one of the Exceed is made in HSP, so HSP makes cars for Exceed and many more companies. Don't get me started with the secrets. All right. Mr. Lube Plasky, you are rich. No, I'm not rich, but I'm happy. Alhamdulillah, it's all good. Money is not everything. Why this stream has only 28 viewers? Well, maybe they are sleeping. Maybe the time is not right. I'm not sure. I'll choose another time on the next stream. The next, I'm going to do a couple of live videos for unboxing those ones. All right. Okay, Andy. No, come on, Mr. Pie Lover, please be nice. So I'm gonna hide this, please, Pie Lover, be nice. Andy drew FPV. After your electric skateboard, are you going to get an EUC? What is an EUC? Please enlighten me. I'm dumb, really. Sorry, I'm a dork. Speaking of electric skateboards, I have a Team G electric skateboard, and I enjoyed it. I'm still enjoying it. I had one fall on that skateboard, is that when I was going really, really fast, there was a crack in the road. I hit it at 35 kilometers an hour, and the board decided to slow down suddenly, threw me off guard, straight into the road. I tried to run at 35 kilometers per hour, couldn't, and nice injuries here. Not bad. After that, I had a swim in the river to rescue my quadcopter. But recently, I have been in Dongguan for some business trip, and I tested a new electric skateboard with twin outrunner brushless motors and a belt drive on it. And guess what? At a very high speed, the damn skateboard decided to stop suddenly. And this time, there was a brand new road that I fell on, and I had injuries at 9 places, and I'm still recovering. And that is the reason I'm not going out so often, because I'm still recovering from my injuries. So this time I had here. I can't tell you how many places. I'm still recovering. I'm still not going out, not doing too much exercise. All right, let's going for the next question. So yes, please tell me, what is electric unicycle? Well, Andy, I'm actually thinking to build an electric go-kart by, you know, operating and dismantling my Team G electric skateboard and using those electronics to build an electric go-kart that can actually drift. That's going to be real fun. But I'm on to a unicycle. It's a kind of electric scooter, kind of big. I'm trying to get it to review it. It has been really nice to know that the scooter. I don't want to tell you what it is. Is it? When it comes, you will know. I'm trying to get it, and I definitely would love to try that. But electric go-kart that can drift, that's going to be super fun. Hey, where's my chat? All right, it's back here. I want to know what is the 3D function on FPV goggles? Have you tried on any FPV goggles? Okay, SkyZone V2, SkyZone V3, they are 3D video goggles. They can receive stereoscopic images, one image per eye. So that is left image and right image, but then you need to have a stereoscopic camera with two lenses and a stereoscopic video transmitter that will transmit two streams of live video from each camera, and that video will be received using the built-in video receiver in left and right eye. And for that, I would like to pick something up. One moment. Luckily, I have this right here. So for that, you will need something like this. A stereoscopic camera right here, left and right, okay? And a stereoscopic 200 milliwatt, 5.8 GHz. This is a SkyZone video transmitter. Now, using this left and right camera and left and right transmission, two live streams are transmitted down to video goggles, and each shown in left and right eye, respectively. And trust me, that gives you a very unique image and a very, very unique experience for FPV. For the very first time, when I tried this, I tried it at home on an RC car. I can tell you that when you use this kind of stereoscopic camera and a video transmitter and compatible video goggles, you see an image with depth. Because using like these, when you're flying with the standard video transmitters and video receivers, you do not see depth. You see 2D image. There's no depth, nothing. But when you use a stereoscopic camera, you see depth. You have a depth perception when you fly. And that is one of the most beautiful picture and very unique experience to drive FPV or to fly. Now I have flown with it. I have driven RC cars with it at home, and that was really a nice experience. This does not have much range, but hey, you 200 milliwatts should have enough for 1-2 kilometers if I'm using good antennas. So still, I gotta give it a try. And guess what? And guess what? It's time. You brought me to the right place, to the right point. Guess what? I have just built myself. Sorry, I almost hit my eyes. I've just built myself this big baby. This is OFM Seeker 450 V2. It used to be my best seller. I used to sell a whole lot of these. I used to sell like 10, 20 pieces a month of these that I personally built for my clients. Now I rebuilt this one, and this time I'm using RaceStar motors, RaceStar ESCs, and Master Air Screw 3-blade propellers. A complete build video, a time lapse, and a complete flight video of this is coming very, very soon. So I'm thinking, this is the best time. You put me on the right way, right place. It's gonna fit really nice here, right? What do you say? And I can actually enjoy flying 3-dimensional 3D FPV. This one has a NASA light, so it will always come back. It has auto return to home. Should there be any problem, it will come back home. So I will give it a try. Thank you very much for putting me on the right track, reminding me of that. Come on, hang there and don't drop. All right, so yes, I'm back. All right, where are we? You should talk a bit about you and your background. We have been watching you for years. JC, thank you very much for this question. Let's do another live video show. Let's say in coming days, tomorrow, after tomorrow, something like that. Let's do another live video show on who is alishanmao, where is from, and how did he come to this world, and how did he get into this? I mean, if you hear my story, you will be enjoying it, because there are a lot of twists in there. So let's do another session, live session on that. Who is alishanmao, where he's come from, why he's an alien. We'll do it very soon, inshallah. All right, next. Mr. JC, yes, I will do that video. Don't worry. Make sure you watch live and tell me if you are available right at this time or some other time. So I will schedule that real nicely. All right, Mr. Pilover says, personally, you find the electric boards are missing something. That satisfaction of pushing the board with your legs. I understand. And what they're missing nowadays is that with the electric, they are really, really fast, and they decide to stop throwing you in front of it real bad. Denny Jason says, can you unbox drone parts? What kind of drone parts? You should be mentioning that. Andy again says, I just got one and put a video on my channel. Not sure what you're talking about. Mr. Doug says, you produce an FPV guide on your channel. It was brilliant. Can you provide a link for it, please? Sure thing. Well, actually speaking, I have cleaned up my website. It's only flyingmachines.com. I've completely cleaned up. Removed so much affiliate products from there, and only few categories left, so you can easily find that right there. Only flyingmachines.com, no spaces in between. Thank you very much, Blue Sky. Thank you very much for all your continued support. Danny says, can you please show your flight controllers? Flight controllers, well, mostly I use, for what? For the FPV plane, I'm using the new flight controller that I recently introduced, OFM AP1 Lite, very nice flight controller. For my helicopters, I'm using K-Bar. A lot of people ask me, how did I configure my ALZ RC helicopters hanging here? And I never had time to actually show how to configure them. But now I have a new ALZ RC X360 that I'm gonna make a build video, so I will definitely do a video on how to set up K-Bar with your Futaba. For my GPS quadcopter, I'm still using NASA Lite, my favorite, because NASA does not need to connect to internet for firmware updates. I hate to connect to DJI servers; they just take all your privacy. So I like NASA Lite on that. And one of my personal favorite was X-Aircraft flight controllers. No more. For now. But for FPV racing quadcopters, whatever comes, F3, F4, whatever comes, whatever flies really well, I'm using those. Mr. Ukulele Fatman says, will you be flying over 4G network? Hey, that's a nice question. Answer is, if I have some of that technology for me to test and see how it works, definitely I would love to try that on 4G. All right, next, an ECU. Yes, Andy. Yes, Andy, inshallah, I'll try an ECU very, very soon. Unicycle. You mean the single wheel? Single gyro wheel? Is that thing? I'm actually looking at something which is pretty big. I'm not sure if I can get it, but that's one thing that I'm having in my list. Hey, Dark Matter FPV, how are you? Danny Jason says, can set up retractable landing gear and can show it. You mean to set retractable landing gears on quadcopters? Yes, you have to buy those. Right now, I had those retractable landing gears, but they're in another room. I don't want to walk in the dark to get it, but definitely you can set them. Tiny Whoop, who says that? Super Packet, Tiny Whoop. Speaking of Tiny Whoop, that I would love to fly with my Ishin EV200D. Let me find it somewhere here. So I just got myself my second brushless Tiny Whoop. This is UR65. A complete review will come on my channel, definitely. This is using brushless motors. I mean, if I can pick two of the whoops right here. Come on down. Sorry, you've been watching my big belly. My first brushless FPV whoop was Warlark 85 Pro, and it's still with me. With a ducted fan kind of thing, it works with Futaba, and it's still absolutely a charm to fly this quadcopter. But compared to the tiny whoops, I mean, compared to the whoops, you see, it's big. Still, it's fast, really fast and nice. So I had this Armor 65 with me, which is brushed motors, but it has plenty of power, plenty of performance. And now we have the similar size UR65 right here with brushless motors. Let me see if I can get the camera to focus on it. Check this out. Come on, camera, focus, please. So yes, these have brushless motors. And when you say brushless motors, you automatically assume there will be lots of power for punch and flips and rolls. We'll find out very, very soon if it has that. Because on whoops, I don't like to do flips and rolls. I just love to fly them around in obstacle courses. So that video is going to come very, very soon. Best beginner RC heli for 3D aerobatics. Beginner RC heli for 3D aerobatics. I have one sitting right there. And probably, let me just pick it up. A video is coming very, very soon on my channel for this helicopter. So if you are moving on to 3D helicopters from the beginners, helicopters, the XK-K110 makes a good choice. And then I'm going to make another video that will be on Volcara Super CP, which is a complete ready-to-fly bundle for beginners 3D helicopter, but it doesn't have this much power that the XK-110 has. So choice is all yours. I would suggest get a flight simulator and practice. That really makes a difference. Thank you very much, Mr. Pileover. Working hard every day and every night, actually work late nights to make sure a lot of videos coming and good content keep coming on my channel. Now winter is here and most of the time the weather will be very, very bad. So I'm getting some real cool stuff for myself to stay indoors, like UR65 FPV whoop. I'm getting more RC cars as well, waterproof RC cars, so I can go, you know, mudding, adventures, and yes, FPV car driving adventures. I have a Red Cat Racing Everest Generation 7 crawlers, one of the best crawlers out there in the market. And now we have a metal pickup sitting right there and others. So yes, I'm thinking to do FPV. And I believe if you surface FPV, normally having to have a model down and a video transmitter on the ground, you do not have much range. So a quadversity is going to help a lot on surface FPV. And besides, speaking of which, I don't know if you guys ever did the FPV on RC motorbikes. I did the FPV on RC motorbike, where of course the motorbike had a gyro. It was a Sky RC Super Rider SR4. And wow, I drove that motorbike with FPV camera on board, and I even pulled some wheelies on FPV. It's one of the best feelings when it comes to that. But I had serious glitches on the video receiver side and video goggle side, because model being on the floor, you don't have much range. So I believe this time quadversity is going to help a lot. We're going to try very, very soon, of course. All right, hold on. We have a very interesting question. But before that, Mr. Doug asks, what region of China you are in? We are in central China. That is Hunan province. So if you look at the map of China, you will find Hunan province, H-U-N-A-N, Hunan province, in the middle of the China. And somewhere in the Hunan province, you will find a small city named Zhuzhou. When you look at the map, when you zoom in, the first thing that you will see in Hunan province will be Changsha, which is the capital city of the Hunan province. We are just 45 minutes drive from Changsha city. And it's called Zhuzhou, a beautiful city famous for the industry that developed the city into a big city very, very quick over the year. And that is they have huge factories here to make electric trains, electric locomotion technology, electric trains. Those high-speed bullet trains are developed, designed, and built here in Zhuzhou. And now they have big factories in Beijing and other places. So Zhuzhou is one of the most important cities right here in Hunan because of the train industry they have here, huge factories of those electric trains. All right, Brian says that, can you tell us how drones built and configured in China get shipped all over our alleged globe and fly perfectly fine without being reconfigured, knowing gravity has no effect on the FC board? Well, I believe a flight controller is designed to stabilize your quadcopter, no matter what kind of quadcopter it is or drone it is. A flight controller is designed to stabilize it, okay, because there's an accelerometer, and then there's a barometer to hold the altitude, pressure sensor, and then now they are using vision positioning system with the optical flow cameras, okay, and some sonar sensors, so it holds the altitude. And then it comes to GPS. Now I believe the process or the work, the function of the GPS is to receive the satellite's data and triangulate the position of the drone, and then tell the flight controller, hey, this is the position I have triangulated. You have to stay here until the operator says to move around. So that is the reason they fly very well all over the world. Even they are manufactured in China. I hope that answers the question. Super Packet says diversity EV100. EV100 have diversity, yes, they're okay. Good goggles, not bad. But what I didn't like about Asian EV100 was the screens were pretty small. These big, very big view, that had a smaller view. Goggles were good, but smaller view. This big view, that's what she said, you know, sorry. That's what we like. Big view, that's what we like. Big view is more clear and nice. Left side helis, okay. Let me turn the camera. Okay, hold on. Let me just pick the camera up. Sorry. There you go. These are ALZRC 420 and 505. And as I mentioned, now I am building X360. I'm going to build the X360, and I'll keep you all posted for that. Wa alaikum assalam, Mr. Hussein Khalid. You have a huge RC drone. Can you take permission with police? Well, Denny, at the moment in China, here, especially in the city, we don't have to take permission. But to be responsible, we don't fly bigger drones in public areas or close to public areas. We have dedicated places. So bigger drones, I always go to stadium side or some places very, very far away to test them. So I'm doing my best not to fly quadcopters closer to people nowadays, even the smaller ones. Whoops are fine to fly around people, and being nosy around people is fine. They are safe. Hello, Sunriser. How are you? Mr. Brand says no GPS fitted. If there's no GPS, mostly they will use the optical flow positioning system, a camera looking at the ground and processing the patterns on the ground and, you know, on the built algorithm, trying to hold the quadcopter its position. So that's pretty easy. No GPS is even easier, less glitchy. GPS used to have flyaway. Talking about flyaways, I know. I've been there, done that. Lost my GoPro 4. All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Moy, my Maywood. Thank you very much. Hi, Neon. Hello, Jason. Hey, Jason, Florida here too. Who is Jason, Florida? Dark Matter? You are getting a gray screen. Nerdcopter says he's getting a gray screen on EV100. It could be a glitch on EV100. I have to check with Bangwood on that matter. I have two managers that I can actually check with them on EV100, gray being gray. If you like, you can shoot me an email at alishanmao@gmail.com and I'll check with Bangwood and see if they have a solution or firmware for the gray screen. Thank you, Muhammad Ali. Alhamdulillah, not a genius. I'm an actually very stupid man. I make a lot of mistakes. Danny says, can you make an underwater running drone? With FPV? I'm not sure. Yes, you can have an underwater running drone. It depends what kind of drone is it. Okay, Brian came again and he says, if there's no optical flow fitted, then it will not hold position. It will not hold position. It will have altitude, probably. Hussein Khalid says, what was my first plane and drone? Man, it has been a long time, but I do remember my first plane was a toy plane, which had two motors and I couldn't fly it. And then I bought a single rotor pusher, glider type, upwing type. And I still have that plane in my store down there. I still have it. I never threw it away. That was my very first plane. And my first drone was, I believe, from Lotus RC, a 650 size from Lotus RC. That was my first drone. Thank you very much, Dark Matter. How did you stop that glitch? Do share with us. My favorite RC plane. Well, can't say that, man. There are lots of RC planes. Time by time, they come, they go. Some stay, some go, some crash, some fly away. So cannot say what is my favorite RC plane. Let me see. Time is 10:53 here. Guys, I have only 7 minutes left. I plan to do this for 1 hour live show. And I have a very nice movie waiting for me that I have been watching. And I need to finish it tonight before I go to bed. If you want to know what is the movie, it's called Spanglish. Adam Sandler. I'm watching an old movie, Spanglish. Interesting. I've never watched it before. Nimbus VTOL is not my super favorite. Nimbus VTOL is a good plane, but you can say it's my favorite plane. A plane that stayed with me for FPV long range flights was the Skywalker. So if you talk in that sense, which plane stayed with me for a very long time and I flew a lot of FPV flights on, that was Skywalker. That was one of the best FPV planes ever made. Mr. Pilover, you're in France. You can teach us some French phrases, please. How to interact with you to discuss some RC stuff because you have more knowledge. Thank you. My email is, of course, alishanmao@gmail.com. I'm going to just type it here. So if you need anything to discuss, just shoot on that email, or you can go to my Facebook, which is also an alishanmao, and leave me a message on Facebook. I used to stay away from Facebook Messenger, but then I realized, hey, it's pretty useful. I can talk to a lot of people. So now I do have, let me see, where is my door, window to the world? I do have, come on, Facebook Messenger on my phone. So that's also a way to contact me very, very quickly if you like. Muhammad Ali says, what do I love for RC cars? Or I mean, RC cars or RC planes? Well, you forgot to say RC helicopters or RC quadcopters. Well, it all depends on my mood. I'm kind of man whose mood shifts very quickly. I don't know. If I do a lot for one thing, I cannot stay doing the same over and over again. I shift from this to that, to this to that. So it all depends on my mood. Sometimes I'm into RC cars and I simply love them, and that's why I'm getting more and more. There are four more coming, inshallah. And sometimes I'm into drones, so I fly a lot. Sometimes I'm into RC planes, sometimes FPV, sometimes helicopters. It all depends on my mood. Basically, everything is good. But one thing that I love about RC cars is, if you have a waterproof RC car, you don't have to wait for the weather. You can play them anywhere, anytime. And you can even do FPV on that. And one of my best favorite for RC cars is to have the RC crawlers, because you can do some challenges on that. Bashing, like the Zombie DHK8, the new one, bashing sometimes can get really boring because, you know, going fast, yeah, jumping, breaking parts. But crawling, RC crawlers are one of the best thing, actually. Lots of challenges to drive and lots of fun. Hello, experimental RC. Okay, Swarm Quad, Top Sky Prime 1. All right, I'll put it on my list and see if I can get it. If I can get it, we can actually compare it with the EV20D or Skyzone V3s. Nice to meet you, sir. I believe you're from Japan. Some kind of Chinese-Japanese characters there. You too, Mr. Pilover. Have a good sleep and have a good night. So thank you very much, everybody, for watching this a little bit of long, boring, lots of talk about FPV goggles and long show for about an hour. But hey, it's always good to be with my followers and my loyal followers and subscribers to have a good talk with them. You know, it's like having to have face-to-face talk. And yes, we're going to have more live video shows during this week and the next week. In between the video, I have, oh my God, I have tons of videos to upload. And I still have a lot of videos to shoot and upload. For example, now weather is good, I have to shoot those videos. So I still have tons of videos to upload, but I'm planning to do, not to schedule videos for a long time. This bounds me not to do live shows. I will do in between live shows. So next live show is going to be, as someone asked about me, who I am, where I'm from, how did I become alishanmao, something like that. So next live show is going to be that. And please leave a comment in this video when you're watching, or after that, leave a comment and tell me what is the best time to do the show. Remember, I'm at GMT plus 8, Beijing time plus 8. So at the moment, here is 11 p.m. at 9. So tell me the best time. Maybe I should do the live video show about me in the morning, or evening times are the best. So we'll find out very soon with the comments and your suggestions. I'll leave some polls on my Facebook as well. And then I'm going to do a couple of live video shows on RC cars, definitely. And of course, some more FPV setup and stuff like that. Even maybe build the next RC helicopter, ALZ helicopter, live. That's going to be fun if I can build it live. I can all see and watch how things are going. So stay tuned. Thank you very much for being with me here. And inshallah, I'll be back very, very soon. Have a good night. Good night from China, everybody. If there's night, have a good night. If there's a day, have a good day. Cheers, and talk to you all later. Enjoy, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. There's a lot of amazing content is coming your way. Thank you very much and good night. Experimental RC. Yes, I'm upgrading my paramotor. There will be another paramotor video. We'll talk about paramotors in another live video show. All right. Thank you. Oh, Steve, you got out of the hospital. Thank you. Thank you, God. Steve is fine. Steve had an accident, I believe. Good. Very, very best wishes and really, really good luck to you, Steve, and hope you stay healthy. Hey, I wanted to show you my, injuries, but let's keep it for the next live video. How injured? Thank you very much once again. And everybody stay healthy and stay happy. Peace. I'm out. And good night. Too many questions. I gotta end this. Good night.